second topic of syllabus, that is pointers. So basically you should know about what is pointers. Pointers are derived data type which can store address of another variable. So minimum two variables are required. One simple, that can belongs to integer, float, char. Second is pointer variable. Pointer variable which can store address of another variable. So what is the syntax for declaring pointers? Simple, you have to write any data type, symbol, product symbol, variable name. Int star p, float star fp, char star cp. The p pointer that will points to numeric addresses. Fp is a pointer that will points to decimal addresses and so on. So next is initialization. Initialization means you have to provide some value to pointers. Pointers are always initialized with addresses of another variables. So here we are taking two variable. One is pointer ptr, second is variable I equal 10. So pointer is initialized with address of variable I. So this is the way that we can initialize pointers. So next is double pointer. Pointer is used to store address of another variable. So simply double pointer means pointer to pointer. The pointer which can store address of another pointer is called double pointer. So declaration syntax is star star ptr. Here is an example of double pointer. We are taking two pointers in this class, in this program. Example, pointer 1, pointer 2 and simple variable. In pointer 1 we are storing address of simple variable I. In second pointer we are storing address of first pointer. So today we will discuss four programs, basic that is related to declaration and initialization: pointer to object, pointer to derived class, new and delete operator, dynamic memory allocation. Basic program of pointer. See, we are taking here two pointer and one simple variable I equal 10, star p simple pointer, star star q double pointer, and p is holding address of I and q is holding address of p. So we have to check the value for such combinations. I star I means 10, star I means address of I, p is again which is holding address of I, same address, same output, star p address of pointer, q is holding address of pointer p. So again output is similar to p. Star p means value present at address stored by p. It is the important concept. Star p means the value stored at address by p, value present at address stored by p. So next is star star q, again value present at address stored by q. Again twice we have to use this concept, value stored at address used by p. Again last is address of q. So let's check output for this. Build, run an output. See, firstly we have I, address of I, p pointer, address of pointer, q which means address of pointer, star p means value present at address stored by p 10, star star q value present at address stored by q and belongs to p also 10, address of q. So this is the basic program. Second example is pointer to objects. So we have to use the concept of class and objects here. So we are taking here one class A. This is class A. In this I am taking one data member, that is ID, and two functions, getData and putData. GetData for taking details for ID, putData for printing details for ID. So pointers to object. So we have to create two objects for base class, and one you have to create pointer for base class. Here is pointer belongs to base class and object is belonging again to base class. So pointer is holding address of first object. When pointer is holding address of first object, so then in that case, when we call getData and putData functions, output function to be accessed from base class, main class, that is A. There are two methods for accessing data functions, member functions from class. Simply one is dot, second is referencing operator. So this time I am using referencing operator because I want to access member function with the help of pointer. So we are passing first address of first object. So get data and put data will access ID and ID details, will taking ID details and print those details. Second time, so same thing we are doing by two times because we are using here two objects. Now let's check output for this. So output for pointer to object is we have created two objects, so output is printing two times. Next concept is pointer to derived classes. So we are using inheritance here. One is base class, in this one data member, and two member functions are there, put data and get data. Get data for taking details for data member, put data for printing those details of data member. So one class is inherited from base class and it has some additional features, marks. Again we are having same function, get data and put data. Get data having details for data members and put data for printing those details. So we have to create pointer for base class, and now we are created object of two objects of base class. Inherited classes objects are D1, and we are creating pointer for derived class also, that is PTR1. So basically we have two pointers, three objects, two belongs to base, one belongs to derived class. So with the help of pointer and pointer 1, base class pointer and inherited class pointer, we are accessing get data and put data. So now see output. Let's run this program. Firstly, we are using pointer of base class and holding address of base class object. So when we accessing get data and put data of pointer that belongs to base class, so functions of base class will be accessing. So enter id will be printed. So next is we are passing address of second object, same again that will working from base class. Third is pointer is from base class, but it is holding address of inherited class. This time again id is printed from get data and put data is working from base class. So next is at the last we are using pointer that is belongs to inherited class, and we are passing address of inherited class derived name. So both belongs to inherited class. This time functions are accessing from inherited class. You can see here id is 4 and marks are 10. Aur ye marks humne kahan pe print karaye the, inherited class mein. Last topic is new and delete operator. dynamic memory allocation, we have to use two operators, new and delete. New for dynamically allocation of memory. New operator is responsible for allocation of memory dynamically, and delete will freeze that memory that is dynamically allocated. So see here, we are created one pointer that belongs to numeric addresses integer equals new int 10, means one variable is there, the value of that variable is 10, and pointer is storing address of that integer at runtime. So we are using one more variable j equal 10. Cout p, when we are printing pointer and value present at pointer, output will be output will be 10, that is dynamically assigned. After assigned, we can freeze that memory by using delete operator. Delete p will freeze the memory of pointer.